Good evening, everybody, and welcome. All of our hymns are posted on the board up front and are also listed in the programs for this evening. Our Mass setting tonight will be the Mass in honor of Pope Paul VI. And as a courtesy to everyone here, please remember to turn off all electronic devices before Mass begins. Thank you. Thank you.
Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mystery. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father.
God, He wrote, Father forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains, by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response is, blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
Praise you, servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
From the rising to the setting of the sun is the name of the Lord to be praised. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is his glory.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
Who is like the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high and looks upon the heavens and the earth below?
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
He raises up the lowly from the dust. From the dunghill he lifts up the poor to seat them with the princes of his own people.
Blessed be the name of the Lord forever.
It's an honor for me once again to preside at the annual May crowning. I would suspect that many people who are not Catholics would wonder about why do Catholics do such strange things. But really, we are acting according to reason, that it is reasonable to honor our parents. In fact, a person who doesn't honor his parents is committing a sin. And our parents are not merely earthly parents, although they are our parents. But we have heavenly parents. Mary is our mother, and Jesus said, honor your father and your mother. Jesus gave her to us when he was on the cross, John chapter 19, behold your mother. We can see that many people have done this. The greatest man of the 20th century is a good example of this. He was shot 35 years ago tomorrow as he lay slumped over in his Pokemobile, which was filling up with blood. He called out for his mother. Not his earthly mother, his heavenly mother. I'm talking, of course, about Pope John Paul II. When he was 9 years old, his mother died. A terrible blow to the family, to be sure. But as he grew older, he recognized that he had a heavenly mother. And so he began to take notice of her. A similar thing happened to St. Therese, the little flower. When she was small, 3 or 4 years old, her mother died. But she developed, over time, a great appreciation for Blessed Virgin Mary as her mother. In fact, I remember visiting Lisieux, which is in Normandy. Normandy is in the north of France. And I walked into the Carmel. Carmel is the convent there, where she had entered, and there was a statue of the Blessed Mother. This was the very statue that smiled at little Therese on Pentecost, which was May the 13th that year. Interestingly enough, we were there on May the 13th, without any planning, it just happened. Another one of these God incidences, as some people would call them. We call Mary our Queen because she is our mother. And in biblical times, the queen was not the king's wife, it was his mother, such as King Solomon, Bathsheba, who was his mother. To recognize her queenship is to recognize the kingship of her son. In fact, the rite of crowning is very specific to indicate that whenever there are two statues, the Blessed Mother and her son, the son is always crowned first, and then the mother. She takes her queenship from his dominion. His dominion is a dominion of hearts. It's not a political thing. And he has given us the Blessed Virgin Mary to be our great advocate. Anyone who gets to heaven will see exactly the beauty of this lady. To be in heaven is to be, of course, very close to God and to be close to his mother. It is a privilege to be a Catholic. I say this with humility because we understand the place that the Lord gave to her. It was his idea. We should always be thankful and respectful of ideas that come from God. And all women are elevated in her. Blessed art thou amongst women. We should remember that. It's the great expression of God's love for women and the important place, part that they play in the human race and in the world. In fact, one of Pope Francis's intentions for this month is that women may always be respected. I find it very ironic that many effeminates have nothing to do with the Blessed Mother, if they so call feminists. She is the ultimate feminist in the best sense of the word. And we should remember that. She shows us her son. Mary leads us to Jesus, and Jesus leads us to Mary. The two of them work together. Blessed are you, Lord God, heaven and earth, for in your mercy and justice you cast down the mighty and exalt the lowly. Your marvelous wisdom is shown above all in the Word made flesh and the Virgin Mother. For he, your Son, freely humbled himself even unto death on the cross, now sits at your right hand and is radiant with unending glory. The King of kings and Lord of lords, and she, the Virgin who wishes to be called your servant, was singled out to be the Mother of the Redeemer, true Mother of all the living. Now she is exalted above the choirs of angels and reigns in glory with her Son. Pray for all of us, the Queen of Mercy, pleading for grace. Merciful Lord, look upon us, your servants, who by crowning this image of the Mother of your Son, proclaim him as King of all creation and approach her as our Queen. Give us the grace to follow them and serve you, to do what love demands for the sake of our brothers and sisters, to deny ourselves and spend ourselves so as to win our neighbors for you, to be lowly on earth so as to be exalted in heaven, where you reward your faithful servants with the crown of life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Mary, Virgin, forever most worthy Queen of the world, pray for our peace and salvation, for you are the Mother of Christ, the Lord and Savior of all. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now let us humbly pray to God our Father, who has done great things for the Blessed Virgin Mary, continues his marvelous works in the Church. We sing.
Our response will be, Lord Almighty, hear us. For the Church, that in union with Mary, it may proclaim the wonderful works of God and make his mercy known to all nations. For he casts down the mighty from their thrones and raises up the lowly. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Almighty, hear us.
For all the peoples of the earth, that under the impulse of the Holy Spirit, they may be gathered into the one people of God, under the rule of Christ the King. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Almighty, hear us.
For harmony among nations, that through the prayers of the Queen of Peace, hatred may be laid to rest, war extended, and all the earth enjoy prosperity and peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Almighty, hear us.
For those who endure illness, poverty, loneliness, imprisonment, or persecution, that the Blessed Virgin, the Queen of Mercy, may strengthen and encourage them with a mother's care, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Almighty, hear us.
For all who are present, that recognizing the unique dignity of the Blessed Virgin, we may try to imitate her humility and spirit of service, and daily love her more and more, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, Almighty, hear us.
For all the souls of our beloved departed, especially for that of Audrey Miller, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear us. Lord, through the prayers of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, whom you have given us for our Mother and our Queen, grant that we too may share in the fullness of your grace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let us pray. Having received this heavenly sacrament, we humbly pray, O Lord, that we who reverently celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary may merit to be partakers in your eternal banquet through Christ our Lord.